members, friends, relatives, and the business community gathered at the All Saints Cathedral in Nairobi for a memorial service to celebrate the life of the late Bethuel Mareka Gecaga. The late Gecaga passed away on Thursday and is survived by his wife Margaret Gecaga, son Udi Gecaga, husband to the President Uhuru Kenyatta's sister Jane Wabui, and grandchildren Soya, Jomo, and Nana.
You are the definition of a gentleman. You taught us right from wrong and inspired us to be the very best that we could be. We love you, Babu. We will miss you, but you'll live in our hearts forever. With lots of love from Soya, Jomo, Nana, Sansi, and Alexander.
Gecaga was eulogized as a dedicated husband, father, and friend, with many remembering him as an ever-happy and kind man.
And I could always depend on him during good and bad times, with lots of humor and laughter.
Mourners described Gecaga as a man who passed rare integrity.
He was a perfect gentleman. Dignified, refined, immaculately dressed, and charming. Those of us who knew him when he was puffing his famous pipe, he was admired by many the way he did it.
Born in 1924, Bethuel was one of the few indigenous Kenyans who went on to make a mark in the corporate and public service fronts. He served on several senior managerial and board positions. He served as general manager and chair of British American Tobacco BAT Company for 28 years. The late Gecaga also served as the chair of the governing council of the University of Nairobi. He also served in the board of several blue-chip companies, including the Nation Media Group, Industrial Development Bank, Commercial Bank of Africa, and Kenya Airways. He was also a trustee of the National Famine Relief Fund and National Fund for Disabled.
No one of us was born without a mission. But it will be very sad if we lose the mission in which we came into this world.
Gecaga will be laid to rest tomorrow at his Yadini Coffee Estate in Ruiru, Kiambu County.
All to thee, my blessed day.
Michael Njenga for Citizen Weekend.